All right, well, welcome everybody to Helpouts Summit Provider Number 3. I'm Jeff Bond. I'm a Helpouts provider since day one. I'm glad to be here and co-hosting this wonderful event with my friend Kim Beasley. So how you doing, Kim?
Hi, I'm excited to be co-hosting with you, and thank you for asking me.
Great. Okay. So what we want to do is really just spend a lot of time letting providers discuss issues, bring up topics. I've asked for a week for input and had several great talking points. We've organized it into a list and have a lot of, I think, just real top-tier providers that are going to share lots of ideas. And we're looking for positive things as well as ways to make the platform better. It's come a long ways. There's recent news about helpouts in competitors and things going on, so it really pays for us to be in tune. And I think since we're helping set the direction to positively, constructively contribute to the platform, so that's what we're here to do. Kim, any kind of intro words or things that you'd like to say?
Yes, most definitely. We're going to be having people come in and out so that different ones can give their opinion on different topics, and also some people may be staying throughout, and that's Nick and I believe Kia will probably have something to say on all the topics. And so as we transition from group to group, please be patient with us, and you are going to have opportunity to give your own input. I believe Jeff has the question, the Q&A app turned on, so that means that if you have a question for anyone inside of the Hangout, or if you have a comment you want to make, please make sure that you ask the question, use the Q&A app, and get your point, your comment in, or get your question in.
All right, great. Thanks, Kim. Just one other thing is that we want to try to let a lot of people speak, so we'll be brief, and then where buckets are worthy of expansion, we will. But remember, this is all being recorded, and the idea is to put this information out in public so that later on people can look back and think about Helpouts when it was brand new and know that there was a lot of participation from individual people and working towards seeing what gets made out of this platform. All right, great. So topics are up, and and what are we going to be talking about this first session here, if I could ask?
Okay, so during the first session, I will bring up my screen and share it.
I can do that, actually. Have some fun over there. We're going to talk about the ringer control. Nicola had mentioned better ways and options to use that so that you don't get 80 pings when you're trying to talk to somebody.
Yeah.
Opening up helpouts to more countries. We want to talk about policy and terms of service changes. It's hard sometimes when these things come in and we're not prepared for them. Also, just creating new helpouts, how it's been much improved in the workflow. Also, a couple really important issues is separating business maybe from individual helpouts. Some people say it's like getting squashed by a large company versus just being an individual. And also some ideas about Helpouts outreach, ambassador programs, getting Helpouts to the community. So with that, those are the topics. I'm going to sit back and let people enjoy it. So anybody, please feel free to speak up.
Cinda, I got a few questions there. Maybe I'll start.
Great, Nicola. Thank you.
Well, the first one, as I said, the ringer thingy. I mean, I've been asking a few times now. I find it very annoying. I think many people like the function, so I'm not saying to take it off. I mean, it's probably useful for many people, but for me, I mean, time ago when I used to get lots of helpouts, you know, it was like a continuous helpout after the other one. And having the ringer ring, you know, on your mobile and then on your G+ page because you're logged in into Hangouts, is quite annoying. Then you switch off on your mobile and then it still rings on your browser. So then you like to take it off. And sometimes even if you take it off, it will still ring while you're actually doing the helpout with a customer, and it's very distracting. That's my experience. I believe that other people likes it because, you know, they get a ring and, you know, they get reminded to just run to their computer or to their tablet and do the helpout. But I'm pretty sure of, you know, when I have a helpout and so I don't need enough. I mean, there's already enough reminders. I mean, you got an email reminder, you got a calendar reminder, you know, there's plenty of reminder there. I believe there's an SMS reminder as well. So it's just a question of adding a simple button, you know, that says disable.
So how many devices do you actually use, Nicola, as part of your notification system? Cell phone, laptop, a desktop, or is there more, or how do you...
For notification, all I need is the, you know, I get a calendar entry, the half an hour before a Helpout just pops up, yeah. And, you know, I don't use the SMS because I don't need that, and I get an email as well. I believe the email is, you know, and those settings are actually there in the settings on the top right when you're on the Helpouts page, and you can enable or disable them. The only one that you cannot disable is the actual ringer. The reason why I say that is because I use Hangouts for my SMS on my phone. So if, and that's fine, but if I wanted, you know, I got lots of G+ friends, and if I want to receive a message from them on my mobile, I cannot because I'm signed out because I'm worried about having this ringer, you know, when I'm doing a Helpout. So I'm actually using half of the potential of Hangouts just because of this.
Let me make sure I understand what you're saying, Nick. You're saying that you don't want the ringer on the mobile?
No, it's not. Yeah,
only you want the capability to disable the ringer.
Yeah, because
on any device in a desktop. Is that it?
Okay. The reason because the only way I found to disable it is to log out of Hangouts, not Helpout. Okay. Log out of Hangouts everywhere. So, and I don't really want to do that, but I'm forced to anyway.
Okay, no problem. What are Kia and Ian? What do you think about the ringer?
As far as the ringer on my end, I have not had an issue with it because I only put notifications on for mobile only. So my phone is usually on silent. I do believe there is a setting where you can choose where you want your alerts to come to. So you may want to look in and see if you have the ability to disable the alerts for platforms that you don't want it on versus the ones that you do. But I have mine set up for mobile only at the time.
Okay. Thank you. Ian?
My desk blows up about 15 minutes before my Helpout begins. My phone goes off. My tablet goes off. Second phone goes off. I get all these notifications up on my desktop. Honestly, it doesn't bother me. In fact, quite often I'm usually just coding something here at home, and all these alerts start going off, and I'm like, okay, I got 15 minutes. And then because everything synchronizes to my Google Calendar, at 10 minutes until I get another reminder and a bunch of stuff pops up. And honestly, I don't mind it. But generally, that last 10 minutes, it sort of prompts me, like, okay, go in, because I tend to send a lot of surveys ahead of time to people. I go in, I double-check all the survey things, make sure I've got all my notes prepped, I get my laptop ready, I get my headphones in, and then I turn everything off. I turn my speakers off, I turn my phones, my tablets off, I turn off every notification. Generally, I keep the monitor on in front of me because that provides a little bit of extra glow in terms of light because my Helpouts tend to be at nighttime. But other than that, everything else on my desk gets completely shut off, so there's no background noise, etc. And so honestly, the notifications don't bother me that much, but your mileage may vary.
Okay, thank you.
Real quick, is I think it just really highlights how we all use the platform differently, so we should have a granularity of control within settings wherever possible so that each unique provider can kind of custom tailor their notification systems. I've talked with Ian before, and he works through dings and bumps and dings and that, so I like to turn things off, but it kind of highlights how the system where it has flexibility to allow us to choose and dial things in differently is probably a unique nice feature. Kim, so what's next?
So let's go with the next topic, and guys, I just want to just mention a reminder, let's keep our answers brief to give everybody an opportunity to talk so that we can cover all of the topics that we have today. We have a lot to talk about. So the next one is open up Helpouts to more countries. What's the timetable? What benefits? Personally, I don't know if they're allowing us to know which countries are going to be next or the timetable. I think this was a topic brought up by Nick.
Yes. Well, you know, it's been a while. It's been 8 months now that we are on the Helpouts. And I don't have a problem because I live in the UK, and you know, Helpouts provider from the UK can join, no problem. I believe that even 8 months in, there's a lot. There's a lot of people that don't know about Helpouts, and I think there's a lot of interest in it because the people that really want to become a provider, they all know about Helpouts. Doesn't matter what country they are in, and I believe that enabling, let's say, Helpouts in some of the Asian countries or Europe, South America, will bring in a lot of providers, a lot of interest, and possibly will expand the knowledge of to normal people, you know, that Helpouts actually exist. That's my small opinion, but I believe they will improve, you know, getting people to know about Helpouts.
Okay. Any other opinions about opening up the Helpouts to other countries?
I think some of it also may be that Google is simply wanting to perfect what we have right now, because, I mean, as it is, we're still actually in beta, invite only. So I think that may have something to do with it as well.
Yeah.
If I may, as a software developer, we learned pretty early on, start small and iterate and gradually grow things. And in my startup coaching help out, I often tell people, hey, whatever business you're starting, start in your own city and then build out, you know, gradually. Don't try and go international on day one because it's not going to work. And so I can definitely see how they would scale this out, first with the beta invites and then open it up, but keep it as a beta platform, but open up to more and more countries. It's unfortunate that they can't tell us the timeline of, you know, when other countries are going to come on for providers or consumers, but, you know, that's kind of the nature of the beast, I think, to some extent, with a lot of Google services, not just the Helpouts platform.
Right. It's a rollout time, and I think they're trying to perfect what we have in place now and get things rolling and get as many, you know, bugs, kinks out of the way before they actually open it up to everyone else. They've done that with all the products that I've ever used with Google, and I think it's just one of those things where it's a wait and see with the Helpouts.
You know, Jeff? The irony with Kim is that it always seems like the place that needs it the most gets it last. And, you know, especially when it comes to help, I think the idea is you're trying to be a service to somebody else, give, and specifically to people that are in need, not that want. And then, ironically, is all this technology, it's great for us, but where it really needs to roll out the most to do the most help is the most unlikely place it'll be. So that's why we try to keep on helping others as much as we can, because there's always something to be done.
Most definitely.
Yeah.
So let's go on to policy and TOS changes. If we and this was brought up by Ian. You wanted to know how can we better know about it and prepare for changes.
And I'm going to go here really quick, Ian. This is a hot button with me because we need to plan as individuals how to work within the bigger system. And I look at it like a big, huge flock of birds. We all got to be turning the right direction to keep things moving. Otherwise, there's lots of collisions and lots of inefficiencies. So it's a real hot one for me, and I talked to Ian about this, but he's got some good points, I think, worthy of talking about.
That was actually a really good analogy, Jeff. We all need to move in the same direction at the same time, and as providers, it's hard for us to plan ahead of time when we don't know what policy changes are coming down the pipe. In my case, this past week, I received an email from the Helpouts team, very generic. It was just signed from the Helpouts team saying, oh, hey, we noticed you send out a survey. You need to publish that survey link in your Helpout text. And I responded back. I'm like, well, no, because I don't want to get spammed. Like, it's a Google form. Like, I don't want to end up with people providing information in this survey where all I'm asking them for is their name and then information about their technical level and, you know, and so on, just pertinent to the actual Helpout session. But there's nowhere that they actually type anything in. It's all pre-selected choices. And at the end of it, I'm like, by the way, I need your name so that I can match up who signed up for a session and so on. And that's all part of a pre-canned message that I send ahead of time. But the Helpouts team was unrelenting. They're like, nope, you got to have it. You got to put it in there by August 8th, or we're going to shut off your listing, I think was the implied meaning. But basically, they said I had until August 8th to comply. And so I kind of raised a stink, and I actually sent some messages to Hannah and to the team at large. And I'm like, look, I'm happy to let you guys preview all of my surveys ahead of time, but I'm not willing to publish this. And I held my ground on it. I said, you know me, I've complied with everything, you know, throughout, you know, my development time. Like, for example, working on that Chrome extension, I didn't publish it because they asked me not to. Things like that, and I'm absolutely, I love the Helpouts platform, and I'm happy to oblige them when they ask for something. But in this case, I held my ground. I'm absolutely not going to publish that. And I spoke with Chris Lim about it, who's another Helpouts provider, and he actually published his and says he hasn't gotten spammed. But I actually held my ground on it, and I actually received a message back from them Friday, late in the afternoon, and they're like, okay, because all you're asking for is their name, that's fine. But if I were to ask for their address or their email address or any like personally identifying information, they would want that ahead of time so that they could see that as part of the Helpouts listing. And my first question to them when they brought this to me, I asked them, when did this policy go into place? This wasn't announced anywhere. This wasn't brought to anybody's attention. Like, you're hitting me out of the blue with this policy that supposedly exists. I got in a video chat with one of their guys right away, and he's like, yeah, I think that one's fairly new, but I think it's been around. Let me put you on hold and find out. And he came back, and he's like, yeah, that one's brand new. It's like, well, how are we supposed to know that as providers? And so then I got on a call with Jeff and realized that was kind of a hot button for him too.
So let me make sure I get this clarified. What you're wanting is a way for us to be notified as providers when there is a policy change and when there is a TOS change.
Well, not just when there's a change. Let us know ahead of time. Like yesterday I received some emails from some other site saying, hey, in a week we're going to change our terms of service. So you have a week to go and read and make sure everything's compliant and whatnot. But for them to hit us after the fact and say this policy is already in effect, it's like, well, shoot, now we're all on the defensive. We have to be reactionary with it.
Okay. Gotcha. Anybody else? Everyone else pretty much have the same feel, I believe, that it's really great if we can know ahead of time so that we can prepare. I know I got that same message in, and I went ahead because I am asking for more than just a name, because I am sharing a document after my sessions with them as a follow-up, and it's easier if I have their email address that I can immediately share the document with them during the session instead of, oh, what's your email? Oh, you know, I tried to get all that information up front. So, yeah, I totally understand where you're coming from, and I understood where they were coming from too. So
yeah, and so do I, given other conversations I've had with them about my Chrome extension, how they want to make sure their privacy is kind of first and foremost, and I totally understand that, and I'm willing to comply with all of that. But my main argument to them was, when somebody signs up for a Helpout session, I already know their name. I just need their name again in the survey so that I can link up who submitted which survey results. But I told them it's also a bad user experience if I publish my survey results and they get taken to some other page where they fill out a survey, and then maybe they're confused about, wait, does that sign me up for a session? Do I need to go back and still sign up? And so I explained to them, like, it's going to be a bad user experience, and they actually agreed. And they're like, yeah, you're right. And they relented on it. And they were very open to the conversation. That's my main point, is they were very open to having a conversation about it. Not that they're breaking away from the policy, but that they were willing to work with me as a provider to figure out how can this policy work in this case. And they were really great about that.
Let's move to another topic now. I'm not trying to be mean or harsh, but we have 9 minutes left and we have 3 topics. And I want to make sure we get them in. The next one is new Helpouts creation process. Much improved and structured flow, a workflow. Nick, you mentioned that one?
Yeah. That was asked by Jeff on what do you actually like about the Helpouts. And I think that's one of the best changes they did recently. And, I do like the new layout of the Helpout page. For the provider, and it allows you to, you know, especially for someone technical like me on the computer and electronics category, where, you know, your experience is important to describe what you do, and, you know, the ability to, you know, describe every single thing you did and even more, I quite like it. And the process to get there as well is, I think, is a little bit better. Before, you only had like two different text boxes, and you could put certain things on one side, certain things at the bottom. Now it's a little bit more detailed, and it's actually more clear on which detail you need to put where. And it actually looks much better when a customer goes on the on your page and it actually sees, you know, your LinkedIn profile, your Twitter profile, and, you know, I quite like it. So changes like that, I'm very happy with.
Awesome. Anyone else want to speak to that topic?
Yes, I agree. I really think that it's a lot more intuitive, and it makes it faster to actually get it filled out, because before it's like, what should I put? Have I put too much? And things like that, and you didn't know until you went back out to your published Helpout to see what it looked like. So I like this a lot.
Ian, do you?
I haven't actually made a new session in a long time. The only thing I've been able to do is go in and add my videos several months ago when they came up with that policy of adding new videos to Helpouts. So I haven't seen, I barely saw the new workflow back in the spring when we had to add our videos. But aside from that, I haven't seen the new workflow. Maybe I'll add a new Helpout just to see what it's like.
Come on now.
Hey, I'm well established with what I have, so I don't need to be more busy.
I hear you. I totally understand. Okay, so let's go with the next question, which is separate business from individual Helpouts getting squashed by big can't participate. I believe that's a Nick one also.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's something that I noticed lately, and I mean, there's always been big companies on the Helpouts. Maybe they weren't as popular as recently. The most popular one is becoming Samsung USA. And you can see that, you know, I've been quite popular myself on the Helpouts since the beginning. And I did get quite a few Helpouts. I mean, of course, I'm free, and so I do attract a lot of customers. But I don't know, since a month and a half, it's been very quiet. Even though I'm online, not many customers actually come through. It could be also the summer, people is on holiday, so they have other things to do. And I believe, you know, there's quite a few companies there where, you know, they're big businesses. And I believe that even for the customer to have these separations, like, is he a business helper or is it a private person that, you know, is selling their skills? Or giving the skills for free, I believe that, you know, it makes more sense. And even for the big businesses as well, they have a separate page.
Not many customers actually come through. It could be also the summer, people is on holiday.
So Jeff has given us a little bit of a replay of what you just said.
They're big businesses, and I believe that...
Video. Someone, Jeff, you have your video going. Like,
is he a business alpha, or is it selling their skills.
Is he just playing back or something?
Yes, he accidentally got kicked out and now he's back in, so he was listening.
Okay.
Thank you, Nick, for sharing about the issue. Yes, there are big businesses, and I think one of the things I would love to see is the categories reworked to separate out even more, and give additional categories. Like, there's one that I really, really have been bugging them about getting, and I'm hoping it'll come up soon. Ian or Kia, did you have?
Yeah, I do think that it would be, I can see both sides of the issue, because this, coming from a corporate background, the Helpouts would be huge for corporate, as far as some of the postings that I put suggesting like the Helpout part of the call center and things like that. So it's very intuitive for better customer service, and I think Google is reaching out to them for that reason. But then at the same time, as entrepreneurs, we have to know we are in competition with those businesses, so we need to advertise and take advantage of the tools and the Helpout Providers Hub and the other resources that we've been given to advertise.
I think it would be helpful if the Helpouts team could help the smaller entrepreneurs market a little bit better. You know, a bunch of us have talked about getting like AdWords credit or you know, things like that to promote our Helpouts, because we are competing against very big companies sometimes. I think that would be really helpful if it were possible.
Yes, and that's
hold
one of
on
the
second Kia. Hold on, Kia. Jeff had a comment. Hold on 1 second. Go ahead, Jeff.
Real quick, and then I'll pop out of here because I'm interested in hearing what Kia has to say. But is I kind of like to be mixed in the pool with the big boys. Is it kind of gives me some exposure? You see Home Depot, you see Home Advisor, then you see Jeff Bond. You go with that. So, really, is let's be smart about this. Is we have a larger pool, and you know, there's a deep end, there's a shallow end, but we're all in the same pool. So we can share that, and we can leverage and just be smart about putting up ropes maybe to define space, but within even searches, maybe the relevance can be the lowest price, the highest reputation, and maybe another one is geographic location close to you, and another one might be small business. We have ways to flag this, but I like the idea of being mixed in the crowd, so hear your thoughts.
Yes, and that was another thing that I was going to bring up. When someone first arrives to Helpouts and they see you mixed in with those large companies, that's going to increase your value immediately in their eyes. If you're using, well, everyone's using their name for their Helpout. So, for example, if you're using SEO to optimize, you should be showing your Helpout, or at least your overall Helpout link, as one of your top 10 Google links that come in when someone searches your name. I know for me, it's showing at about a number 8, but definitely I have a lot of resources about marketing and things like that, so I've been coming around to start sharing a lot more as far as tips and how to market and how to get those SEO results. I think if we all step in to help each other out with our individual expertise, that's also going to help build the community and help us all in the long run.
One of the things I want to share real quick, and then we'll go to the next topic. If you have your listing optimized for the keywords you want to be found on, this is what can happen to you. So if someone looks for a Google Plus business coach, they're going to see my two Helpouts right here. I have my name first, and then I have Google Plus business coach. If you have your name first and your keywords in the first 150 characters, I believe, the Helpouts rank real high. And just to let you know, I am not logged in. So if you want to rank for your Helpout for your keywords, make sure you put your name and your keywords in the first 150 characters.
Of your listing?
Yes, of your listing.
And so then it automatically percolates.
And I have it in my title. I have it in my title also. So I have it in my title, the first 150 characters of my listing. And that and Helpout's ranking at the top anyway. But if you have it with your keywords, it ranks you at the very top, like this.
I see. Very smart.
And that's just one way. And I get traffic now, just so you know, I do Helpouts by appointment.
Yep.
And I get traffic to my Helpouts. So I'm not worried about the traffic. Mm-hmm. It's positioning yourself, like Kia was saying, SEO. That's very important. Get your keyword and in your title, get your keyword in your first 150 characters, and you can get up there with the big guys in the search engine.
Atta girl. That's smart advice, and I think that's just all part of the whole new paradigm of social media that small businesses really need to tune into, because maybe we're good at what we do, but we're not really good at running a business that like supports what we do, and that has to be a major component in running a small business. I found that over 25 years the hard way, so mm-hmm. I hope everybody watching is willing to recognize that these newer tools need new methods to be optimized, and it's worth being aware of those little subtle differences because they matter a lot, apparently.
The last topic. Can we carry it to the next time?
Yeah.
Because the person who brought that up is not in here.
Okay, so, let us do that. So
let's bring the
Okay, so I will do that. Let me kind of pop over and make some invites, Kim. And in the meantime, is
someone over there? And in the meantime, any of the topics while we're waiting for others to come in? Now, just guys, so you know, we are expecting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more people. And if anyone needs to leave to let them in, I just want you guys to be open to that.
Yeah, it looks like we don't have a problem any time right now, Kim. So everybody's welcome. Yeah, lots of good stuff going on. Okay,
so please stay if you don't have if we don't have to have someone leave to get more people in. Any topics you want to revisit while we're in the holding pattern for the rest of the people to come in?
Well, I can touch on that last. I believe it's for Sherry, the Helpouts outreach, getting Helpouts to the community, schools,
et cetera. Hold on 1 second. We're saving that one.
Oh, okay. So she's going to come in later? Okay.
We're going to save that. Yeah. Let's revisit the first 5 that we covered already.
Mm-hmm.
Any of those. I know that you were talking about, I think we need to go back into the separate business from individual Helpouts, because that right there is a point that we are really trying to encourage all help out providers to step out and start promoting yourself. Step out and try different avenues. Sometimes, you know what? I found that sometimes it helps if you volunteer to do free webinars for organizations. They will supply you with people at the webinar. You go in, you do the webinar, and you give away a freebie at the end, get them to sign up to get the freebie, bam, you have their information that you can add to your mailing list.
Yes.
And you get their permission when they do the download to add them to your mailing list. So hey, I would definitely, yes.
I'm sorry, real quick, just an interruption. Ian's going to say bye-bye, so I wanted to say thank you, Ian, for 1 second here. Let me try something out here, if I can. And Melanie's popping in, but I want to try this show. Yeah, this works. Before you ditch Ian, let me see.
We have more.
I did the showcase.
Freebie, bam! You have their information.
Oh, if you have the video on, please turn it off. Pause it.
Mute it.
I believe is that Mark.
Yeah. I'm sorry, real quick, just an interruption. Ian's gonna say bye-bye, so I want to. Ian, I'm not sure if you can see it here, but I'm trying to showcase. Hopefully it's showing your Helpouts on the live feed broadcast. And thanks a lot for everything. I really appreciate it.
No worries. I'll be back a little bit later for the open discussion. My bandwidth's a little crazy right now, so I'm just going to shut it off.
Yeah,
a little bit. So I'll see you guys in a couple hours.
Okay. Hold on a second. Mark, you still have it on. Or, no, not Mark. Who? I thought I still heard it. Mark, I muted you. Can you unmute? I don't think I have. No, I don't.
Showcase. Hopefully it's showing your Helpouts.
Okay, yeah, you still have it going, Mark.
And thanks a lot for everything. I really appreciate it.
No worries. I'll be back a little bit later for the open.
So when you turn it off, Mark, then unmute, because that is playing back and we can all hear it and it's going on the video.
No kidding.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Real quick here, I'm going to just showcase a few of the people that were
yes, go ahead.
First time and just get them in here. So I'm
showing your Helpouts.
Go ahead, go on, Mark.
Hey, this is Mark.
Mark, hey, Mark, turn off the video. You have the video on. That's why you're getting feedback.
There's Ian. And I'm curious how this thing works. Maybe we'll see Larry and Cosman next time. And I got a message from Sherry just a little bit late. And let's get a showcase up for Kia. Awesome. Is Kia still in? There you go. Thank you, Kia McLean. Lots of good ideas. I really appreciate it. And Mark, hopefully you were able to turn that off. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the showcase. And Kim, right back at you, my friend. Thank you.
Okay, awesome. Thank you guys for joining us. So we have joining us Melanie, and we have Mark joining us, and I believe that's all they joined us. Yes, yay! Welcome, welcome. And we have Kia still with us. We have Nick with us still, and me and Jeff. So this time we're going to cover different additional topics, and we have a lot to get through, so we're going to try to get through all of them. Let's go ahead and let's jump into Helpouts outreach, getting Helpouts out to the community, schools, etc. I know that's a Sherry topic, and she can, if she's able to make it later, we can cover it during open discussion. But let's go ahead and talk about that, and let's be brief. Remember, everybody wants to talk about the different topics, so let's kind of keep our comments to 30 seconds, a minute or less, so that we can get everyone in. So, Helpouts outreach.
I say that, Kia, if I could ask your thoughts on this, you talk about ambassadorship, and I'm interested in what you're thinking about. So any thoughts that you might share would be appreciated.
Okay. Well, actually, one of the reasons that I bring up ambassadorship is because there is actually a Helpouts ambassador program. I believe there's maybe six of us in it, and it is all about outreaching to the public about Helpouts, and we have codes to give out so people can come out and try the Helpouts. So I was really interested, for those of you that don't know, we just went through a major medical issue with my husband. He had a brain tumor, went through brain surgery, so I'm really just now getting back. One of the first things I wanted to do was a community outreach to my own local community, which went very well. And then I wanted to reach out to the providers and connect with you guys and really get the ambassador program of my enrolling and help you with those advertising issues and marketing questions that you have. And really just form those partnerships to help you get out there and be recognized and known.
Yeah, well, like I think that like the post that you shared, you have a couple good models to let people work with as a beginning start point. So I really appreciate that. And that brings up just the point of our provider community. There's tons of good stuff in there. There's a few categories I would like to see added back. I think it's a little thin, but you know, it's structured well, and it sure is populated with a lot of good input. It's one of the better communities I've ever participated in.
I think when it comes to outreach, there have been some really unique things that people are doing. Kita's doing some really great things at the community. I believe Stephanie has been sharing in the Helpouts community how she's gone out and talked to different groups and how people are like, what? What are Helpouts? and she's been able to educate them about Helpouts. I think when we get out of our virtual box,
I hear you. Thank
when
you.
We get out, no, I'm not voting. when we get out of our virtual box and we actually go out in the public and we make these connections, it is a way for us to grow our visibility. It is a way for us to make those connections that can bring us clients. I ended up talking to one of the pastors on staff at my church, and they are going to let me have one of their community meeting rooms free. And let me explain this. My church is high tech. They have Google TV. They have Wi-Fi. They have all of that. I can do hangouts during my trainings. Wow. Reach out, church. Go to your community centers. Go to your libraries. Reach out. Try to find other places where you can offer free training, and then you can get people involved there in your Helpouts.
Melanie, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Jeff, and thank you, Kim and Jeff.
Yeah, we're happy to have you here. Big uptick, and hope your little doggy mascot's doing good. I'm waiting for another big uptick shot with my dog's ears, but they're hard to come by. So, I love your
show.
A lot of nice hangouts, and I think that you augment Helpouts well with that. So, I know it's not a topic, but I wanted to just say that I think that your combination and the use of multiple different platforms on Google is smart, and I think it comes across well.
Thank you, Jeff.
I think so. Yeah. So. I'm not sure if you had any topics up here that were listed or if you put anything down, but What are your thoughts on Helpouts? Might as well kind of just see what you're thinking about these ideas.
I do agree with Kia that it's important for ambassadorship. And I agree with Kim as well to step outside of our virtual box. And with what I do with online marketing, I have to be in my virtual box for about 90% of the time because that's what I'm about. You know what I mean? So if I am helping others with their online presence and with Twitter and YouTube and everything else, then that's where my audience comes from. Where I've discovered if I talk at my local library, they're not really there. You know what I mean? Because they are just there. Sometimes the people are there, and the discussion goes above their where their current capacity is understanding the internet itself. So I have to be very diligent in remaining in my virtual box and spread the ambassadorship through all the social media platforms as I can with Helpouts as well.
Thank you. Thank you.
I was virtually lost for a second, so please have a look.
And if you're in the Hangout, please make sure you have the chat open.
Yeah, blue box in the chat.
Yeah, we're going to be sending some messages.
Mark,
are you unmuted?
Yes, I'm here.
Oh, great. So let's get to your first question. Tune your listing with AdWords without spending any money. Huh?
Yes.
Really? Okay, yes. Tell me your idea on this one, how you can do tuning on AdWords and not spend money.
Okay, here we go.
And keep it brief.
I'll try to keep it brief. When you create a Helpouts listing, you have two problems. You have to come up with a really good title and a really good description. The people who do AdWords advertising, they have the same problem. They have to come up with a really good headline and a really good description. And they only have four lines of text to do it in. So when you do a Google search and you see the little ads pop up on the right, those ads are the best of the best. They are the ones that have survived the AdWords process. So if you need a title for your help out, do a search on your topic, take a pen and a piece of paper, write down some of the ads that you see. One of those headlines would be a really good title for your help out. That's my idea.
That's pretty tricky. So you're basically saying you're just looking at the pool of winners and you're just picking the winner as like your title. And
those people have already done all the split testing. They've spent all the money. They've put in all the effort. We're just taking advantage of what they've already done.
You see Kia doing this. Can you tell them why you're doing that?
Kim has already heard her strategy.
You know those are going to be good headlines because Google was telling you these are the ones that get all the clicks. These are the ones we like.
Yeah. And that is the thing. Google took away the organic search tool so you can see what the most popular terms are now. So you see this not provided by the majority of what you have up, but you can still use the Google Analytics. Some still come through as far as what people are searching for, but it's really important to stick to what people are searching for because that's how you get found.
That's right. And if I can just build on what you just said, if you create an AdWords account, you don't have to spend any money. You just have to create an account, then you can log into AdWords, then you have access to the keyword tool. Then you can look to see what people are actually searching for. Once you have that list, that's your blueprint. You make sure that you mention all those things in your Helpout listing.
And that kind of ties in with the next question. Jeff, I'm going to let you come back because this is something you're interested in, AdWords credit as a possible incentive across Helpout's platform. So all of this kind of ties in with the AdWords kind of thing.
And I would say also is if I make him, you know, as a small business owner for 25 years, no complaints about playing with the big boys because, hey, look, if you want to elevate the game, go play with somebody better than you. So it's not a complaint, but sometimes you need a little bit of money to make a little bit of money. And sometimes just that little boost and a head start helps. So I'm not for money being thrown around for free here, but it's sometimes nice for smaller entities to have just a little bit to work with. So, you know, maybe AdWords credits or some way, because you never know when the next big idea is going to come from just a small spark. It's nice to somehow let small entities play in the game at the meantime is, you know, not make it unfair. But it's a tough subject. There's a lot of ideas around it, so I don't have an answer.
Yeah, my idea on that would be to approach Hannah and basically go at it at a learn-to-earn angle. Basically, that's one of the things that I'm doing right now. Like, I have a whole 90-day free trial coming from HubSpot. Because I'm learning, I'm in the Accelerate with Google Academy right now. So I've always found if I'm willing to participate and I'm willing to learn, then I reap the benefits from Google. And I would really love to see something like that to be integrated here into Google Helpouts, or at the very least I can tell you about the resources I know about, like Accelerate with Google. If you're not signed up for classes or if you haven't gone to sign up, it's an amazing tool for learning. Again, you get 90 days with HubSpot for free, and it's a great way to learn some of these tools that you need in order to be successful. That's and good. It's, of course, yeah, through Google.
Nice.
Man, this is a hot topic, because it involves promotion. Once again, we're brainstorming ideals to help each other as providers come up with ways that we can get our message out there. I am actually going to do an alumni event at University of Phoenix on Thursday. I'm taking Kia with me. We are going to pass out Helpout cards, postcards, business cards. It's going to have our code on it. If you are an alumni, get out there, get involved, let people know that what you're doing with your Helpouts. There are just so many different ways to do this. The next topic we're going to cover, better integration of Google Analytics with Helpouts platform. Now, I do admit I was one of the fortunate ones who had the opportunity to put my set up Google Analytics to connect with my Helpouts. I don't know if that feature is available anymore, but I can see where everyone wants to see what's working and what's not working.
Well, that was my topic. That's what I added to the list, and I think it's really critical, because right now you don't even know how many people are viewing your listing. That's just a basic piece of information that we have to have.
Well, and there if
you've used analytics on your own website, you know that there's just tremendous value there. You can see how many people are visiting, what countries they're coming from, what time of the day they're visiting. I mean, there's a huge amount of information there.
Melanie?
I was going to say something that helped me fill that gap where I don't know how many people are looking. I encourage every Helpout provider to create their hashtag, where it might have Jeff Helpouts, Kim Helpouts, Kia Helpouts. Mine is hashtag Melanie Helpouts. And that has been tremendous help as far as awareness, because hashtags are searchable in Google search. So when you have assigned yourself your hashtag and share it often, Jeff Helpouts or whatever it is, that gives you, like I said, it fills that gap where you don't know until we do get the analytics side restructured.
Yes.
I just want to, hey, Nick, I know you're tech-savvy too, so what do you, I'm sorry to interrupt real quick, I want to just catch what are you thinking about AdWords and everything these days and how it plays out? Is you obviously have a lot of successful help out. So do you use them or you don't use them? Would you like to use them?
I would like to use anything that could be available, but I never really used AdWords. I just, you know, my Helpout. I do use my social networks. I use Twitter. I use Google Plus. A little bit Facebook as well, but that's mainly for personal friends. I use Facebook for personal stuff, and Google Plus is more like Twitter. You know, you do more business stuff with it. And I have to say that if you follow the Helpouts team on Twitter, in my case, they had lots of they actually go around, and when they see a question about my Mac doesn't work, because I deal with Macs and mobile phones and stuff, they're very good. You know, the Helpouts team, I mean, the social part of the Helpouts team, they actually answer to those people by sending them a link to my Helpouts. And then what I do there is go back to them, sending them a reply, saying, you know, just feel free to come to my Helpout and, you know, stuff like that. And they have a tendency of favoriting these tweets as well. So basically, if you go to the Helpouts page, I mean, not in only my case, you know, there's lots of other providers that they help out. So it's good to keep an eye on their Twitter page and on their Google Plus page as well. I was lucky as well to be a helper of the month for June.
Congratulations. Yeah,
and nice. That brought in a little bit of more social feedback as well. So, you know, you get lots of people looking at that on the page, and maybe people that don't know about you suddenly, you know, they see all that, you know. And what do I do as well in that case? You know, I will post that on my LinkedIn, I will post that on my Facebook and everywhere else, and apart from getting congratulations, you also get, oh, maybe next time I'll go and I'll ask Nick if I have a problem with my phone or this. And you do get quite a big push from those things. I'm not saying, you know, everybody's going to be a helper of the month, but the social network part I think is very important. If because it's your own business, let's say if you had a shop, you know, what would you do with your shop? You want to go ask Google to promote it for you, you will do it yourself. And I think that's, you know, the main thing. Now, getting back to what I said before about business and non-business Helpouts, you know, someone like Samsung or Know How, which is PC World, and someone else, they got, you know, very massive websites where their products and stuff, and they have a support page. So why do they get lots of people like that? Well, you know, if they use that as their main support, of course people will just go for it. And so we don't have such a big audience. We in our small, you know, social networks, we can do a lot, and you know, by promoting it. And I believe AdWords might work, but unfortunately, it's not something that I actually used. I do use Google Analytics just to see where my, you know, where people comes from to look at my Helpout. And I have to say, because I'm free, I get a lot of people from countries where Helpouts is not in. So especially India, Pakistan, you know, Southeast Asia, South America, places where, you know, having help for free is very important. So that's why I stick to being free, because, you know, first, it feels good to help, and second, you do get people, so you're not just waiting a month before you get the next help.
You do that well. Or anything. So, Kim,
we are at the end again.
Yeah, all right.
We are at the end. We have about 5 more minutes. We have time for one more question that's on the list.
Let's see. I would like to hear a little bit more about, like, Melly. Unmute that microphone, my friend. Is I can never get enough of you. So, and Mark, technically, because this is a nice blend of application, the use of, as well as the definition of technology. This is a great.
The next question is going to cover that.
Yeah.
The next question is going to continue. More promotion of Helpouts across Google product platforms as a whole, not individuals. This is one that was brought up by Mr. Jeff himself.
Yeah. Well, you know, just the sign of an active mind. But I think that we can all work together synergistically as well as independently to create a chorus where we resonate in sync, and we make big waves out of small ripples. So I just kind of want to hear some thoughts on this one.
Yes, I do. I do think it would be helpful for any of you that are on clout.com. You probably heard that they've been, another company owns them now, and they have actually partnered with Bing now. So for those of you that were invited to the Clout Experts, your answers are now coming up in Bing via Clout for people that have questions directed at your area of expertise. And I know that
I... Hold on a second. Can you back up and explain what you mean by that? Because it may not be clear. What do you mean by answers are coming up? Where are these questions coming from?
Okay, so Clout, before the switchover, they started a program called Clout Experts. And people that had a high Clout score consistently were invited to that program to provide answers to specific questions. Now, these questions are now being broadcast from clout.com to Bing. So when someone goes for a search query, your Clout profile will actually come up. So I've had several what they call a K+, which is just like the plus one here, come from across the internet because people are finding me on Bing as a result of the Clout Experts program. So I really think that it's no accident that we're seeing Helpouts now and that this is Google's answer to that. And it's really a point of staying competitive, and they just like Clout had to work out their issues and get their platform stable, I believe that Helpouts is on that same path, and they don't want to push it out to the public to that extent until those things are ironed out. Because
Can you spell it out, please?
What?
Not all know that Clout is spelled with a K.
Oh, yes. Clout is spelled K-L-O-U-T.
.com. I'm sorry. I'm pushing her because she knows. I know I can push her. Kia and I are really good friends.
Good.
And,
push her.
And I'm like, come on, more. I agree with Kia. I'm part of that program, and okay, I admit I've sort of ignored it. I've answered questions, but I haven't, like, pursued being part of it. And now that you've said it as part of being, I will pay more attention to it. Anybody else part of the Clout Answers?
I got to plead ignorance on this. I need some more help here. Is putting the message out across all the social platform appears to be a very, very fundamentally basic and important task that I'm lacking on. So I don't have any good input here. I need some work.
Melanie, do you have input about getting your message out on other, across social?
Mm-hmm.
Across? Go ahead.
Yeah. I think also what I do personally is I always, let's say 98%, I plus one my fellow Helpout providers whenever they post, because that camaraderie helps others be aware that I'm not alone in this, and then if it directs people to say, oh, why did she plus one Kim Beasley? Who's Kim Beasley? Then they'll take a look at your profile or Jeff Bonds or anyone else. And I think that is so, so important. And it also builds relationships. One neat thing that, like, Jeff and I, you know, we banter back and forth here and there. But I tell you, it was so exciting when his dog had his big uptick ear and it looked like, you know, like my mascot could, you know, have some puppies with that mascot. And it was really neat, and we ended up having some conversation about just these dogs with their ears up. And I think if we promote each other, just plus one, maybe mention where we saw a post like from Sherry Norami, that just helps tremendously bring awareness to the Helpouts platform.
Yes.
It is important. Go ahead, Jeff. You're about to say something.
No, I'm just smiling because I had a great moment with Melanie one time was just popping up a picture and then just a real impromptu, genuine, and really appreciated. And I think a good post popped up just about dog ears pointing up. So you never know where these little triggers are. And the more we communicate, just like Melanie said, support each other, is I think the more opportunities we have to learn about and take advantage of those synergies that sometimes if we don't explore them, we don't even know they're there.
Yes. And I think another thing that's important is to see Helpouts as a community, and it's not us against the big guys, because I work with a lot of corporate, corporate is the background I came from. So, I mean, I can see both sides of the picture being the entrepreneur, so I try to be in the middle and bring the two together, because you don't know, the corporate, they value you as well. So some of the ideas that you have, those are the things that corporate is looking for, and then some of the ideas that corporate has, that's what we're looking for. So I really think if we treat it more like a community and not so much as a sector platform, that we'll see much more success together versus we have group A, B, and C. So I really that's one of the closing thoughts that I had is to stay together as a community and treat each other as community.
Mark, go ahead. As a quick thought on that too, I saw that. Why don't you go ahead and share that, Mark, because I can't wholeheartedly support that idea enough.
Oh, I just posted a note that said, I don't view other providers as being in competition with me, because everybody has their own little niche. They have their own pricing model, their own availability times. I mean, there's room for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I was just going to say real quick that it is important that we do things as a group and that we support each other. Now, when it comes down to being with the big boys and playing with the big boys, let me give you an example real quick. I have a team of people. Well, I can't say team when I have two or three, when I have three people, but I'll say I have a team of people. We provide support, WordPress help desk support for a major corporation. And this is the number one furniture manufacturing company around the world, Steelcase. And they found me from my activities on Google Plus that I spread to LinkedIn. I kept coming up in the project manager search for a WordPress person who does training. And so I got hired. I'm going into my third year. I have a five-figure contract with them that keeps going up every year. I get paid to train their dealers. I get paid to have a support desk. Now, how did I get this? Because I'm playing with the big boys. I'm playing in their neighborhood. So if we have the big boys in our neighborhood, they're bringing their people with them. So you never know. They may bring in customers to you by having them come to them, if that makes any sense.
It makes complete sense. I keep on rediscovering this tool and thinking I have it figured out, and then I'm just going, I'm just a baby. So the understanding comes in layers, it seems, and I have to learn to add first before I can multiply, and then before I can do calculus, I got to figure out how to multiply. So I'm finding that this communication, especially with sharing other people, helps me do that. So mm-hmm. It makes a lot of sense to me, but I'm still learning.
And we have our third group in, and we're going to go with our third group of questions. Now, when we finish these questions, we may not finish all of them, but when we finish these questions, we're actually going to have an open session. And so this during the open session, and Molly, can you be?
Yes, I can hear everyone.
Can you mute? You have background noise. Can you mute?
I do. Yes, I can.
Okay. Unmute when you talk.
I had it sounded like a second monitor or something. Andy, you can unmute yourself there, brother. I wasn't sure. I was tracking down some background noise.
Okay. So we're going to discuss these topics. And if we don't get through all of them, don't worry. We're going to have an open session where I've already moved some questions to the open session. And those we don't get to, I'll move them to the open session. So we're going to start with Help out business listings for small to medium-sized businesses, SMBs. Jeff.
I'm going to tackle that because I really am an advocate for this, is Kim, is I'm so much with Kia here on the fact that small business can learn tons from the corporate world. And in the meantime, corporate world loves our innovation and our ingenuity on the small side. And it's this melting in the middle that allows the two to kind of coexist that really is fascinating to me. And the only thing is a life struggle of doing this. But I've learned one thing. You're not going to get any kind of free help from big business. And you shouldn't. You should earn your way. And you should learn to kind of like climb the steps one step at a time. So I've learned when I thought I was bigger than I was is I didn't deserve to be there. And the market's really good about kind of showing you where you properly belong. That I just think that the platform's going to really be successful, and it's a huge dynamic benefit for corporations to run even internal help if they want, and small businesses to offer help for free or for money, and it somehow allowing this playground to exist for both is really fundamentally important for me. So I'm struggling to play with ideas, and I very carefully track what works and doesn't. And I try to kind of position myself well, and a lot of like the idea has been presented with words being in the proper listing location, the first 150, and the way that you structure your ad and your listing is tons of good ideas here, but there's a lot to play with, isn't there?
Yes, most definitely. Does anyone else have feedback about the help out business listings?
Yeah. Isn't it a little bit more like what I was saying before about big businesses having, you know, a separation from the other private individual? You know,
it's interesting, Nicola, because, you know, on one hand, I want to be exposed with them. As Kia well mentioned, is that exposure is great for you as a small entity. And at the same time, as you don't want to get stepped on when you're there, but if you're not there to get stepped on, then you're not there to get exposed. Is mm-hmm. kind of a double-edged sword. Mm-hmm. And I think learning to tiptoe and tap dance effectively in a fast dynamic environment with big things moving around is probably the best approach as individuals, but it requires a lot of work.
Yeah, and one thing that I completely forgot to mention, if you as a provider are not using email marketing, you are missing out on one of the best tools. I mean, studies are showing over and over again, email beats out everything that you can do. Even if people aren't responding back, they're reading and they're clicking. So if you don't have MailChimp or something to keep track of your email campaigns, you really need to make sure you're collecting email addresses, creating your mailing list, and then sending out campaigns. It is the number one way to market online is email. And be sure not to get distracted by all the new shiny things and all the new technology. What some may consider old school, like customer service and the email marketing, it all still works. There's a reason that businesses were long in existence before all of the technology came along. So that's one thing to keep in mind as well.
And that's go ahead.
No, I'm open. I want to hear. This is awesome. So I want to hear more thoughts. Molly, how are you doing? Molly is muted. You might have to unmute your mic if you get a chance, Molly, and we'd love to say hi and see how you're doing. Your microphone's muted.
Hey, how you doing? I actually agree with what she's saying. In fact, I actually I'm an advisor in the small business community, and I just did a video. It's called the Friday Five, where the moderators pick five questions from the community, and it just so happened one of the questions was how do you market yourself online without using a big budget. And so I was actually looking for the link, and I can't find it at the second, but as soon as I get it, I'll post it. But I agree, email marketing, online marketing, social media marketing, that's how I'm finding people.
Yeah, it's it's important that we all have a way to find our target customers. And I want to ask the panel. Okay, pop question. How many of you have ways of capturing the email address of the people that you do help outs with?
Not
I saw one hand go up, two yeah. hands.
Every single page on my website has a contact form.
No. I'm talking about Helpouts.
With Helpouts?
Yes.
I have a Helpouts link on my email signature. That's really all I'm doing right now.
Okay. Just a suggestion of what I'm doing. I have a pre-survey that I send to the people once they sign up with me, and I ask them for that link. I mean, their email address. I asked them, what one question do you want to ask me in our help out session? And that gives me an opportunity to set up a document that I share with them and also an opportunity for me to follow up with them. So if you're not, if you haven't set up something in place, set something in place so that you can follow up with people. That's really a great way to do, and now there is actually a policy in place. If you're asking people for their email as a help out provider, you have to include the survey link. You're supposed to include the survey link in your help out business listing. So I really want to encourage you to have a way to do follow-up if you don't have that in place now. So that was the pop-up quiz. No more. Well, I'm not going to say no more. I'll try not to ask any more pop-up quizzes.
Teacher, I didn't pass again. Oh, no.
Come on.
Well, hey, real quick, can I share something?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, Andy, you made that little promo video, and I was really digging it, and Kim was really digging it. But what we don't want to do is... We don't want to show a video within a video, just in case it's a problem for copyrights, et cetera, because we don't know if all the providers in that video you put together would approve or not, so we're not going to show it. But I'm going to share the link because it's really cool. And then people can, if they want to, go and take a look at it. But it's a real nice, dynamic, fresh piece about Helpouts, and you do a lot of cool things with it. So I wanted to say... I liked it a lot, and thanks for putting that together and sharing that with me. I really appreciate it. Andy? You're mute. Yeah, I hear you, brother. Nice work on that.
I was really impressed with I went through a lot of videos, and I was really impressed with people when they go, "Hi, welcome to Google Helpouts." And that short little clip, I'm going to encourage everybody to send me a little clip. Because that's me editing out their long intro and then just taking the little clips and pieces. And I want to make like a nice one because I was unaware of the ambassador program. So I'm involved with a couple of halfway houses and things like that where I'm going to be taking my mobile trailer and a screen and a projection screen and schedule some pre-scheduled help outs so that I can have an actual small audience ask each one of the help outers questions.
Sounds awesome. You'll do a
promotional video for that, and it sounds like the ambassador program would be a great program to belong to.
Yeah, good. Well, that was like nice work. Really appreciate that. It's like I'm trying to share the link in the showcase, but yeah, thanks a lot. All right.
Okay.
Thank you. Get back to you.
All right. The next question is Jeff and I wanted to talk about. I don't know how many of you are. Or how can I put this nicely, multitaskers, and you need a second camera and control software and Google Glass integration. Hint, hint, the person with the Google Glasses on, we have two in here, they need that integration. So that's the topic. I would love to be able to have a second camera and have control software. There is not an app that I'm aware of that allows you to do that internally to the Hangouts. There are apps that allow you to do it externally, but you have to be tech. You have to be a techie to get that to work. I used to do that, and it's a lot of work. Your thoughts, Jeff?
You know, I find that if it's really important for you, people as a whole, we find a way to get things done. So if you add a little bit of granularity of control for cameras with the second camera control within a help out, and then you're just able to kind of selectively boot box from one to the other, I think that users would be able to follow through. For example, a chef would go, okay, I have one camera that lets me talk to a person, but I have another camera set up to actually focus on the food, and when I have a point I want to make to the person that's relevant to, here's how the food should look. I think a cook can figure out how to switch the camera over to that presentation view and then bring it back. So I'd like to see a little bit of additional control on cameras. I think it would be wonderful. And since we're teaching people things, a lot of times we're using our hands, and that hands-free approach and with Google Glass or with another remote camera seems to make sense to me.
Yes,
any
I definitely agree. Yes, I definitely agree. I would love to see that functionality as someone else that makes high-quality videos as well. So I think that would be awesome.
Yeah, other ideas? Melanie?
Well, I was thinking some came to mind, but then again, it's that learning curve. Do we have time to learn, and do we have the capacity to learn all of the bells and whistles of a new additional program?
Well, the thing, too, that really kind of hit me was your comment earlier is that with what you do, 90% of your time is effectively spent online. And for what I do as contracting and inspecting, is 90% of my time should be offline. Uh-huh. And, you know, the way that we use the tools so differently are important, but maybe some tasks are more suited to second camera and some are not, but I could sure sometimes use the third hand, it seems like, with a help out. In short.
Yeah, I think if more help out providers could do generate their own HOA show on a weekly basis, you're going to automatically build your YouTube content, which people love YouTube, and then you could just repurpose that. That's why I have two shows, and then I'm a guest on a third show. So I do a lot of shows because I build that content. And sometimes I'm overwhelmed with editing the content, but I would really like to see more providers do that.
And congratulations on passing. Yeah, well, can I go ahead and congratulate you for passing that YouTube Creator Academy? That's quite good work.
Yes. Thank you very much.
That's also consistent with Kia's message to continue to educate and take advantage. So how much did that whole program cost you, Melanie?
Zero.
Right. And did you get some value out of that in the education? I find that amazing, right? So we have to take advantage of those tools.
Yeah, and you just have to, like anything else, you put your time in, and I really, you know, there was so much to learn, and I really did beyond and above what I needed because I saw how it could benefit me if I did those exercises.
Awesome.
Hey, it's really important.
Welcome to the Google Small Business Community.
I opened up a link that Molly.
Okay, so are we putting Jeff in timeout now?
Yep, Jeff's in timeout, so Kim's in charge.
Who agrees with me? one of the things that I really will challenge the providers to do, once again, get out of the virtual box. Not only virtual box as in get out of the house and take your message out to the world, also get out of your virtual box and go do training with Google. There are so many opportunities as an entrepreneur that you have with Google. There's Accelerate with Google. That's a course that Kia and I are taking together, 12 weeks, where we're learning about AdWords, where we're learning about HubSpot. There is Google Your Business. There is Google for Entrepreneurs. Just get on Google Plus and Google. And you'll find all these different communities and pages that you can get involved with. It's time to come from behind the camera, and it's time to stop saying, I need you to get me out there. I need you to push my provider listing out there. Guess what? The tools are there. You just need to step from behind the camera, step out of your virtual box, and take advantage. If you need a list of things that you can do, we can provide that. those of us who are already stepping outside of the virtual box, we can start a post in the community with links, and you can add to it. And it's one of those things where we have to take control of our own business success and make it happen. Okay, I'm off my soapbox now.
No, you're not off your soapbox because you've got a job now. Is you got to help Mark made a comment, we'd appreciate it, is you got to help us put together a list of links of places for providers to go so that they can explore these options, because you mentioned so many good ones, Kim.
Okay, we'll start a spreadsheet and share the link in the...
Well done.
We'll share the link within the community.
Thank you.
One of the things... yeah, I think that's going to be a Jeff and Kim project. Yeah, I'm pulling you in on it too. The next thing is calendar integration and scheduling. How's it going? Does it work? Okay, this was a topic that Jeff and I discussed. I don't even manage my own calendar. I'll start out with that. I have a VA who has banned me from my own calendar, which means that I'm serious. I'm in timeout because every time I touch my calendar, I mess it up. Trust me. And we don't want Kim touching her calendar. And the integration between the Helpouts calendar and the Google's calendar, it's kind of hard for her to be able to manage my calendar. And she see that there's a Helpout space on my calendar, and she's like, "Do you have something scheduled?" I'm like, "No." And she's like, "Well, it's on your calendar." So I had to explain to her, and I'm not sure how many people know this, the Helpout calendar, it takes up half of the width of a column if you have nothing scheduled. If you have something scheduled, you'll have two of them side by side. And that's like
I'm going to ask you one quick question, Kim. Do you, my life revolves around my calendar more than my phone.
Me too.
Email. So I'm just asking, is that the way it works for you too?
My life, yes. I wake up in the morning, well, before I go to bed at night, I look at my calendar. Okay, what time do I have to be up? I don't have anything to 1, so I don't have to do anything with anybody to 1 o'clock. Yes! Okay, that's me at night. And in the morning, I wake up and I'm the same way. Yes! So my life revolves around it, which is why somebody else manages it. I wish there was some... an easier integration to where if there is not one scheduled, that it's not showing up on my calendar. But as soon as it's scheduled, then it shows on my calendar.
All right.
Anyone else?
I want to hear some thoughts. Because my world revolves around the calendar, too.
Yes, I had to remove it, remove the integration because of that. We have special needs children that have appointments on the calendar. I have the business on the calendar. Our lives revolve around our calendar as well. And the Helpouts, it just took over everything. Like you would see one thing scheduled, and then the Helpouts is taking the whole block behind it. So there was no way to separate anything. So definitely, that's one of the reasons I stopped using.
Got it. Hey, can we say a quick hi to Sherry? How you doing, Sherry?
Nice to see you. Sherry's speaking here. Sherry, I'm going to put you in timeout.
Hi, Sherry.
I'm putting everybody in timeout today. Do you guys think Sherry has to answer the quiz, the pop quiz?
Yes, I think she does.
So, Sherry, do you have a way of capturing the people who do helpouts with you?
No, I don't, and I'm worried that it's a good idea. I'm worried that if it becomes too widespread, then people, I'm not saying you're doing that, but people will tend to put those people on their mailing list and keep sending them emails. And over the long run, people that might discourage people from using the Helpouts if we bug them too much afterwards. So if it's a good idea to try to capture their email and maybe, you know, reach out to them, was the session good or whatever, but it should stop there unless there is a really interest from the person, then
in terms of getting into the mailing list? Because one comment that I hear from people when I go out, and I do go out a lot and give workshops about Helpouts, there's a little bit of a cynicism about, oh, people are providing free Helpouts so they can get you on the mailing list and then bug you. I hear that a lot. So although that's a great feature, I think we really need to be careful how we use it. So I have a system, but it's a fantastic idea for follow-up.
Most definitely.
Yes, I agree.
I think when you do have that capturing the email, have a process in place where you're not bugging them. And that all boils down to training.
Yeah, and the privacy policy as well. Like there, you have to be aware of rules. Like because I work a lot with corporate, I'm huge on FTC rules. And FTC rule that you probably don't know about is canned spam. If you're not aware, your business address is supposed to be along the bottom of the email and contact information. And an unsubscribe button. And if you don't have those things and you're emailing people, you can face an FTC fine. So you really have to be aware of the legalities that are involved when you're doing this. So if this is not something that you usually do with the mailing list, you definitely should get educated.
And aside from the legal aspect of it, as providers, we're trying to get people to get comfortable with using this platform. So the less we bug them afterwards, the less we make it look like a way to get their email address, I think people are going to be more encouraged to give it a try. And then one thing that I do is when somebody asks or somebody set up a session, I look them up on Google Plus. If they have a Google Plus profile, I follow them or I research them. And that way, actually, I learn a lot about them before we start the Helpout. So there are other ways to reconnect with people rather than trying to just do it through email.
And thank you for answering the pop quiz. Woo!
I'm a professor.
Put you on the hot seat. Okay, so this is something that I really, really, really wish we could have, and I'm looking forward to it someday in the future. I don't know when it happened. Multiple person help out sessions, one provider, many participants. I know there are organizations I would love to use help outs with. And it would be great if it was a way for that to happen. I know we can do it now where we just sell them, okay, just set up your computer and have everybody just sit in there. What I'm thinking about is where you have multiple people in a hangout along with the provider and you're doing a help out session with all of them at the same time.
Yeah, that would be great.
So what do you guys think about that?
Well, is that just another term for re-wrangled webinar?
Yep.
Say that again.
What you're describing, Kim, is just an upgraded way of a webinar through Helpouts. Is that the idea?
It's technically possible. It's just not through Helpouts.
Yeah.
That makes sense. You can do it in a hangout with Uber Conference. But you can't really do it with Helpouts.
Yeah, so, and you would have to see it done that way or offered that way. Yeah.
I already have corporate clients, even government clients here in the Topeka area that would like to partner with me, and they want their spokesperson to represent them, and it's really hard to do that when the help out is listed under your name, and then there's no way to convert that, because the first thing that corporate's going to look at is, okay, so I have to hire a team to do this, and I have to do this and that, when one person can run it for them or one company can run it for them. So I do think that it really closes off opportunities to us as providers to not have that option available to say, okay, I'll be here at so-and-so trade center, the camera's set up, I do the spokesperson part, and then you have your team in the background doing what you were going to do anyway at this particular event. So I really think that would be an intuitive feature to add.
And one other thing about the multiple person, there are some of us who have small businesses who have a team of people. We would we would love for our team to be able to give help outs through our business. So that is another multiple person help out session, where in the sense of someone from my team can be in a help out and not me. Because it's done through me as a business, as a person, as an individual, I can't do the business part. I would have to try to sign up as my business, but then it's not on a business basis, it's on personal. And I realize it's not available now, but it may be available. Any other comments on the multiple person help out sessions
before we move on? I see that it would be useful for trainers, like people that teaches yoga, or people that other ways of using this, but you know, for someone like me that is in the computer and electronic categories, that I don't really see the benefit of it, unless you want to teach a whole team how to use a Google Plus, but I don't see it. And the other way you should think, the other thing you should think of is, if you're a provider and you're charging for your services, how are you gonna get multiple people to pay for your service? I mean, the same way that you do for one person. Or would you charge different if you are doing a class to 20 people? So that's another thing to keep in consideration.
Good point.
Hey, I'm going to sneak in something here, if I may.
Jeff is sneaking.
This right here. So hopefully I can. Can you guys see my screen?
We see a black screen.
Black?
I can see it now. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. And. So this is a tool that Ian created. This is his tool. But what you do is, you guys all familiar where you can go get your CSV file, your provider report from Helpouts? It picks from that, and then he's like just taking that spreadsheet data, and he has integrated it into one of his tools. It's one of the extensions he wrote. So for example, it shows all my Helpouts. It shows when they were, the month. It shows the time of day. Since I only have one help out, just general contracting, but if you have multiple help outs, it would show you where your time's being used. So we're talking kind of quasi-analytics that address some of these shortcomings that we would like in terms of tools that we don't have. So when people develop these extensions, a lot of times, it even shows, for example, where people are coming from and the device that they're using. I like this stuff, and it's the kind of thing that like adds value in terms of being able to kind of better position yourself based on data that you have to work with, time of day and things. But these are things that, you know, maybe eventually get integrated into Helpouts. But in the meantime, this is why I dig people like Ian that write these extensions and tools, so that we can kind of at least get that data preliminarily while the platform builds itself out. So sorry to sneak that in.
Yeah, you snuck it in. Mm-hmm. there's a comment from Mark. Mark, you're not going to be silent. You have to say that comment out loud.
About the multiple providers?
Yes.
Yeah. A lot of times it would be nice to do kind of a team teaching approach, where you've got two providers providing help out to maybe one or a group of people. Because nobody knows everything, right? I mean, it's great to have a partner there who can kind of remind you of things or put a different twist on what you're saying. Just an idea.
Yep. Thank you for sharing. Let's see. The last question, and then we'll get into the open session, the open forum. last question is, free help outs are part of the bigger system. Using them effectively. Jeff.
You know, I got so many ideas about this, and is they're business related, and then they're not, and then they're just help related, and then they're not. Is businesses that revolve around help are a kind of a funny thing, because for me the idea of helping is to just help somebody out. There's no money involved, but is in the meantime is just that doesn't support itself. There has to be a means to support a platform. So I like the idea that all these help outs are just free or paid, then each individual provider can structure it suited what works best for them. And I'll just leave you with a small story here. I've done nothing but free help outs, and people are all like, bro, you're wasting your time. It's, you know, you could charge money, you could do other things. And I almost listened to them, but I said, you know, it's like I'm here to help out and to beta test a platform and to provide feedback and input. I'm going to stick to it. And all of a sudden, somebody moseys along, and he does a help out with me for free. And it comes back and does another one. And somebody's going, is the guy getting annoying? And I go, kind of. But he asks a lot of good questions. And then out of the blue, he says, how would you like to do my kitchen remodeling job for me? And I go, oh. So now here's a free help out, a free help out, a free help out. I'm 3 hours into this investment. And next thing you know, he's got me doing a $25,000 kitchen remodeling job, which you know, good portion of it is profit that I wouldn't have had as a consequence. So this idea of mixing up the tool and we don't even know everything it's going to do really needs to be explored deeply before we say, get the free out of here because, you know, they're just carving into our profit because that's a pretty good profit as far as I'm concerned. And just a little story about the ways that things sometimes pop up serendipitously we don't even think about. So I encourage you to stay open-minded about it. That's what I wanted to say.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, go ahead, Kim. Go ahead.
Yeah, definitely. That was coming back off of my husband's illness. That was one of the posts that I wanted to get out there like as quickly as I could. And I forgot to post that with my bunch, but I got it up last night about customer appreciation and just I hope that really people really read that and took into account the value that they can create by using those help outs or the free help outs effectively. And it is not a loss. It's just not.
I would like to add that if we consider help outs as our vitamin supplement rather than our main course meal, you know, all of us, we all have our own nutritional needs. You know we should eat a breakfast and a lunch and a dinner, maybe snack before bedtime. And then we go to the doctor and they say, hey, you know, you got to lower your cholesterol or you're low on vitamin B12. Help outs, to me, the help out platform is like that vitamin supplement. So they, you know, to me, I take it like I'm not hinging my success or failure on Helpout's platform. It is a supplement to my main diet of running my business. And I think unless you can adapt that mindset, you're always going to feel like you're failing to perform at your highest on this platform.
Most definitely. When it comes to the free Helpouts, I do a free session. And I have, and this is funny, I did 2 free sessions with 2 different clients. They ended up becoming coaching clients. Awesome. One is getting ready to renew for a third 6 weeks. A second one is getting ready to renew for a second 6 weeks. If you use the free help house correctly, you can leverage it into an ongoing coaching sessions. I offer 6-week sessions at a time, and I'm seeing some really great reaction to that because and when you do the free help outs, you have to set the expectations first of what's going to be done and what's not going to be done in help out. It's not to give advice if you want to eventually upsell them to a paid listing. It's not to give them advice, it's to give them an overview of your knowledge. Because if you're giving out advice, like Jeff, he does, he gives out advice. He's not expecting to get paid for the Helpouts. But right. If you're expecting to get paid for the Helpouts, you cannot give away your knowledge. You have to say, okay, you have one chance to ask me one question. Ask me that question. This is not a session to provide you with answers. This is a session for us to see if this is a good fit. If it is a good fit, at the end, be ready to give them a call to action. Either they're going to buy into your paid listing or not. And you have to make yourself look good enough, delicious enough for them to bite that CTA or call to action.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. That's another reason that I was trying to shift the mindset, because it's a great way, it's a great customer appreciation tool as well. So the Helpouts can be used in so many ways. So don't get stuck in one single mindset of, okay, this is how it was presented and this is how it has to be. Even your existing listings, if you've had the same listing up since you started, it's time to go back and refresh that listing and add something new, change something in it to revive that listing again. So really, I guess my closing words would be, have an open mind. Think from the perspective of someone in sales, marketing, and customer service. I think that is one of the things that a lot of people are cutting out, customer service, and it's so important.
Most definitely. Anybody else have opinion or comments about the free help out listings before we move to the open forum?
Yeah, I mean, free Helpouts, I believe, also are, as Jeff mentioned, because they're still a little bit in beta, let's say, allows people to get to know the platform. If you do a service, if you promote a service that is needed, you do it for free, you probably get a lot of customers, and you are able to help a lot of people. What does that do is allow these people to talk to their friends and say, I had help on this platform. So I believe, you know, I don't believe the Helpouts is grown to a level where it is really auto-sufficient at the moment. There's still a lot to go, and I believe that, you know, if you can, I advise everybody to have maybe two Helpouts, one for free, one not, or do at least the option that says first Helpout free, then you can charge for the second one. Just to, you know, promote it a little bit more. If I were a customer and I never tried Helpouts, I'd rather do the free one first, and then I see how it goes, and then possibly if I need it again, I will pay you for your service. But that's my opinion. And I think that to grow the platform, there needs to be a lot of, you know, free providers.
I cannot agree more. Is this whole idea of being together as a group is, the free providers, they bring a lot of traffic to the platform. Because people don't want to go spend 20, 30, 40 bucks right away, but, oh, something free, I can taste it, a sample at Costco, is let me give it a try. And so, you know, people want to try things before they buy, and there's a benefit in bringing in a wave of people that are willing to try before they buy, and then if there's real value, then you work the dual price system to your benefit of, like, just like you said, Kim, is offering a freebie, but you don't give away the secrets. You just simply kind of help them understand your skills and ability to deliver those secrets, set them up for the sale. And they're all acceptable, and I find them all nice. So I just want to keep and make sure that Google considers the platform's always open to all sorts of different models. I would hate to sure see it somehow closed out or because of financial reasons, all of a sudden there's no free help out.
Well, Stephen, I love the analogy that you gave where you did three different free help outs and it ended up with the $25K project. Dude!
and you know what is, Kim, I would love to say I was smart enough to do that, but it'd be totally disingenuous. Is I had no idea it was coming. I didn't even have a setup. It was just all of a sudden just presented to me. And so a lot of that's just the exposure and you know what, is that dude that asked me, isn't that becoming a little annoying, is I don't listen to him quite as much anymore. And, you know, ironically, that's my own little voice going, man, this is a little too much, or what are you doing here with your time? It's a fine line, but help is sometimes one of those things that you turn it over and you discover a real nugget and a gem underneath. So you never know if even a small little instance of help just creates a huge world of change. I'm all for helping.
Hey, Jeff.
Yes, sir.
By doing those free help outs,
yeah,
you were able to create a real relationship with that person, and they felt comfortable doing business with you. And I think that's probably the lesson of your story.
I would totally agree, Mark, is the value of just in developing some trust and a chance to see that there's some authenticity there from the provider, from the client's perspective, is exactly what the story is about. I 100% agree. Yeah.
Okay, so guess what, guys? I wish I had my noisemakers open. it's open forum time. So yeah. During open forum, we have questions that are kind of lingering out there. It would be great if we could revisit them. And I would love for the open forum to be where we can ask each other questions. So if you have a burning question you want to ask Jeff, Kia, Melody, Molly, Andrew, Nick, I'm trying to see, make sure I call everybody, Sherry, Jeff, or me, please feel free, if you're watching live, feel free, even if you're not watching live and you're watching a replay, ask a question and make sure you tag us if you are watching a replay, and we'll respond to you. So the open questions that are kind of sitting out there that we have not covered, they're really interesting. I don't know where this one came from, Mark, so you're going to have to explain this one. Discuss book title, Failure to Obsolete. And we have Kia, I believe, brought up banners for backdrop during sessions and events for providers who promote offline. We have an agenda for Helpout ambassadors. What help can providers offer to support the platform? That's another Kia. And then we have one that Sherry didn't get to comment on earlier that I'm bringing back in, Helpout outreach, getting Helpouts out to the community, schools, etc. So this is an open forum, which means Kim is not monitoring, but if you get long-winded and I go, that's not me monitoring you. That's me giving you a suggestion to Ian.
I felt that before. You guys don't want to know that pain.
Can I go first?
Go ahead.
Okay, I'll talk about the book. The book is called Failure is Obsolete. And let me try to explain what the book is about. If you go to a swimming pool and you watch people, you'll see two kinds of people. You'll see the people who just have no fear and they just jump right in. And then you'll see the other people, they like to dip their toe in the water first. They would like to check it out before they make that commitment. Right? And so that's what that book is about. It's about how to do tiny little inexpensive tests to try out your ideas before you spend a lot of time and a lot of money. And that's really what it is in a nutshell. It's about 150 pages. It's a quick read. It's just a short little book. And I highly recommend it.
Well, what were some of the main points that like you pulled from it that would really kind of mark is, you know, maybe kind of be worthy is, I would recommend the book The E-Myth, but then I would be obligated to try to figure out exactly what I mean from it. But what did you like about that book?
What did I like about the book? Okay. Number one, don't fall in love with your ideas because most of them are lousy. but there are some real nuggets of gold in there too, and so you need a way to filter out the good ones from the bad ones, and that's really what the book is about. It's about how to do that filtering process and doing it easily, quickly, inexpensively. And he also talks about, you know, building mailing lists and things like that. But the main gist of the book is if you have an idea, think of a way to test it, do the test. If it works, great. If it fails, great. Either way, you've learned something, and move on to the next one.
At least you've tried.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
I said, at least you've tried.
Yes, and you have to try lots of things because you never know what's going to work.
I agree. Yeah. Hey, Sherry.
Yes.
I know I've seen pictures of you in a classroom, it almost looks like, environment full of people, instructing them or giving them information about Helpout. Were you teaching people at a school, or what were you doing? Could you share a little bit about that?
Yeah, I teach about Google Helpouts, and I teach at UCSD, and I include Helpouts into my slides. And actually, this quarter, as I was talking about Helpouts, one of my students scheduled a session for a Helpout. And he went through the session and ended up having something in common in terms of background with the Helpout provider. And they ended up working, promising to work together. So that's at the University of California, San Diego. That's my marketing by new media class. But then I belong to a co-working environment, and we give presentations. So I've given 3 so far presentations about Helpouts, and none of the people in the room knew what Helpouts were. And it sort of got them interested in trying it. And I also learned during these presentations what people find shocking about it, what they don't like about it, and that's the percentage that Google gets out of the fee for the sessions. But I keep telling them, don't think of this as a way of making money. Think of it as a great platform to promote yourself. So, which brings back to the argument that doing free Helpout, kind of that removes that anxiety. So I think I was able to convert a few people that way.
Well, I like it. I like the two-pronged approach, and I like how you're getting it presented into a more of a higher education environment, because you're really kind of you're putting it right in place at right the effective time for people to grasp and use it for their career, as well as also it's just a sweet spot to help out to have exposure from these people.
And plus, in my classes, it's only a 9-week session.
Awesome.
I can't cover everything. Social media is just a huge field right now. So when they go, when they're introduced with the Helpouts, not only they can use that as a tactic to put into their own plan that they're building for the class, but they can also build on what they learned in class to go and learn more.
Awesome. Hey, Kia, I know you had also another billboard I saw up at a presentation that you had mentioned, and I wasn't quite sure where you were at, but it also looked like you were doing something very similar, but it looked like it was an outdoor environment or something. It looked pretty cool.
Yes. Yes. I just here on, I think it was July 29th, had an event that was outdoor and indoor at the local community center in my area, and it was really an outreach to the community to let them know what resources were available to them at the community center. So one of the things that I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be teaching a series of 5 different classes there about how to use a computer, getting on the internet, starting an online business, how to blog, and different skill sets that the area may not necessarily be exposed to because it is a low-income area that community center is serving. And one of my big goals is to help close the digital divide. So that was a great way to actually meet a lot of people in the community that are involved in the government, just meet the local area people, because a lot of people wanted to know, well, why us, and why would Google have anything for us, and that was really nice to be able just to put the smile on the kid's face, the parent's face, to know that their kids can be doing something useful other than hanging out on the streets or something, learning how to code and actually doing something productive. And I think as business owners, we somehow sometimes get so caught up in what's in it for me that we miss the greatest opportunities. And that is something that is a real passion of mine, is to help the youth be competitive, because there are school districts that are in higher income areas where those kids are going to graduate high school and they know how to code. They know how to put up a website. And then on the lower income end, you have kids that have never seen a computer before, as far as the exposure of being able to get on it. They know how to keyboard. They know how to do the basic functions. And we're down to the point now that coding, surprise, surprise, is a basic function now. It's not something you go to college to learn now. So it's really just that depth between the higher income communities and lower income communities, the have and the have not scale, is going to get larger and larger as long as that technology is not there and available for everyone to access and learn.
I agree. It's almost like a modern-day Boys and Girls Club, but the focus seems to be moving a little bit more of an emphasis towards the tech and the computers and the program. But the idea is, it's like just as valid is try to give youth endeavors to pursue that are productive and wholesome. So I like the idea that it's a whole nother avenue, because really is, you know, what are the chances of becoming from the inner city, a basketball star is pretty slim. You know, you can come from anywhere and be a coding hero if you put yourself, right? And so it's a nice door to open up, because I think it's going to provide more access for more people overall. So I applaud you for doing that.
Thanks.
Yeah. Hey, so Molly, I know you do a little work. Could you tell me a little bit about that video that you made? Or I was reading about it, but you said you had done something for a business community. Could you just kind of share ideas?
Sure. Yeah, I am an ambassador in the partners community and also a business advisor in the small business community. And about 3 weeks ago, the moderators decided they were going to do a new series called the Friday Five. And what that entails is they take five questions posted from the small business community and they hand them off to an advisor. And it just so happened they selected me to be the very first one to do it. No pressure. Anyways, so essentially, they handed off the question. They had a little small intro script and ending script, but the person was responsible for coming up with their own answers. And a lot of the questions that were asked were, you know, how do I market my business with a low budget? You know, how do I handle negative reviews? How do I handle customer feedback? You know, just general running small business questions. And so, in doing that, it was a really awesome experience. I've had a lot of feedback from it, a lot of positive feedback. And if you guys get a chance, check out the small business community. It's right now, I think, at about 40,000 people. It's growing every day, and it's just really been an awesome experience.
Yeah, awesome. No, sometimes it's weird, because I will get invitations, it looks like, to communities, and I'm just, I gotta admit, sometimes I blow them off, and I'm wondering if maybe sometimes I'm blowing off a really nice official invite, but that's all part of my social media nativity, as I'm good with it, and there's
lots of social media phobia
out there.
I just know for myself, it was one of those things that I was already a part of the ambassador program in the partners community, and they kind of just grandfathered about a dozen of us into the business community. So that's how I found out about it.
I see. Well, thanks for sharing that. There's a lot of value in that, and thanks for doing that, because maybe you can share at some point the link for that, so community, we can get over, take a peek at it. It sounds like there's a lot of good stuff in there.
Yeah, let me look it up. Give me a couple minutes, and I'll post it here in a second.
You're awesome. Cool. All right. Right back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll jump in here.
I'll just pass you the token. You're welcome to have like a little fun.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me that break. Okay, so while you guys were talking, I did kind of turn my camera off and my audio off. I have food sitting in front of me that has been staring at me since before we started.
You actually started a little before we started, I heard you, but like, okay, so, you know, maybe so, we have a good computer. Yeah.
So that's why I turn off my video and my audio. But to get in to this topic, I want to challenge every provider that's watching, that's listening, whether you're listening live or replay, think of at least one way that you can get out of your virtual box. We've heard all of these examples of all of us that are getting outside of the virtual box. Think of how you can do one thing, how you can go to an organization and say, hey, I want to offer a free webinar for your organization. I mentioned earlier that I'm doing a free webinar this week. I found this one because the organization, they emailed me. It's a small business organization that gives free training to their business members. And I said, hey, would you like for me to do one about Google Plus? And they jumped on it. It's been 3 months in the planning, and now it's here, and I'm excited about it. Do you have organizations that you are a member of? Do you have groups on social media that you're a member of, communities? Go to the moderator and say, hey, I want to offer the, even better, give your coupon code to the moderator and say, hey, let the members know that they can get $25 off by using my coupon code if they come and use Helpouts. Not only are you giving them a discount, you're also going to be making money, even if they don't do a help out with you.
Yeah, that's a great tip.
That's what I did. I gave out my coupon when I gave the presentation.
Oh, yeah, out your coupon code. You make money that way, too. It's just think outside of the virtual box.
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
I've been a part of Dayton. I live in Dayton, Ohio, and the SCORE program, S-C-O-R-E, with the Small Business Administration. And so that's how I kind of that's my out-of-the-box activity. And it's the federal small business loan place, and they have mentors. I'm a mentor for the SCORE organization. And every city should have that.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, Kim. I think that this is a great time just to let everybody have like just a final maybe 1 minute thought, and then we can kind of close out. I'm going to just go ahead and start from my screen left to right. So quick minute, last minute, first, Kia, thoughts?
Definitely. I would love to see us do something like this every month, even if it's just networking. Again, I am a Google ambassador. One of those advantages come with being able to give coupon codes for your help outs. So definitely.
Google partner.
Oh, yeah. And I'm a Google partner as well. So definitely connect with me. I am definitely going to start getting more active on the ambassador side and giving out those free coupon codes and doing events so people can find out more about you and what you have to offer.
Awesome. All right, and Mark?
Great session. I learned a lot. I'm really looking forward to checking out some of those training links that we're going to have posted later.
Yep.
Yeah. Thanks, everybody.
Yep, great. Melanie, can we have some last words of wisdom from you?
I am so happy to have been a part of this. Jeff and Kim, thank you for rounding this up and meeting other fellow Helpout providers that I didn't know before. So let's just keep this going, because this is our first summer as Helpout providers. I mean, the whole platform is our first summer. So it's going to be very interesting of the memories that we're going to have a year from now in 2015, the summer of 2015. So just let's keep the momentum going. And the possibilities are just endless as this grows. And so thank you.
Thank you, Melanie. Hi, Molly. I saw you posted some really nice links over in the chat. I'll work to get those shared out as part of the documents. Thanks so much for that. But
I've been a part of this community for just a short while, but I'm really feel very lucky to be a part of this hangout today. And you know, just like everyone's saying, use social media, use email marketing. Just get the word out about you know who you are and what you do.
Awesome. Nicola, what's up, brother?
Same here. You know, it's always a pleasure to, you know, hear from you guys.
Great seeing you.
You know, being able to help you out with my feedback. I believe that Jeff should be the, you know, official TV presenter for Helpouts.
I can't take that, Nicola. We rally the troops well. I'm glad to accept a little responsibility for bringing the group together, but I'm really kind of just helping organize things. It's really the unique talent of all the providers that makes Helpout so special. That's my personal opinion. So, but thank you, brother. Sherry, what do you think? How you doing?
First of all, I love the Helpout community. It's such a collaborative environment. I don't participate in many communities. I'm very picky, and the Helpout community is my favorite.
Yeah.
Second of all, let's think about, and I did put a suggestion in the event page on RSO QA. It seems like a little bit of a big project, but in risk for getting the word out about Helpout, let's think about doing something like a summit or a conference. We can divide providers with similar offerings into sessions and leverage all of our connections to get people into Helpouts. That's something we can do inside our box, in addition to going out there and giving talks.
Hey, Andy, are you around to say some last words?
No, I thought this was a very productive meeting, and I'm like, Kim, I believe. Not Kim, but I wasn't paying attention. Melanie said that a year from now things will be a lot different, and if we keep this thing going, I think it would be good if we have like a bi-monthly meetup or something.
Yeah, cool. I think that might have been Molly that snuck that in, but Melanie says lots of nice things too. Kim?
Melanie Hall on her. Never mind. Go ahead.
Yeah. No, I'm really kind of honored to have had Kim help me out with this, and I wanted to thank you very much personally and say I sincerely appreciate it. And I very much value the way that you go about what you do. You know that. Don't cry too much. You're supposed to put that hat on so your head don't grow. But you do things the right way in my mind, Kim. You build organic. There it is. Thank you. You build organically and you care. Things really matter to you. It shows. It's genuine, authentic, and I think that's why all the success you have is coming to you as well earned. So I think that I'd like to let you have the closing words.
Okay. Thank you, guys. I love it when we can come together and share our thoughts to help each other move forward in growing our Helpout business. It's about working as a team, as a community, to not only make money, but as a team to help each other grow. As we link our arms together and we move forward with our Helpout businesses, we are bringing each other along. And I love the spirit of camaraderie that we have among us. And Jeff and I are going to put our heads together, get a document going, and that we all can have input into regarding the links that are helpful to each other. We'll have a spreadsheet, and we'll share it in the community.
Awesome, Kim. Hey, before we go, can I just say hi to my friend Rashida over here?
Did we see Sheena come in?
Yeah, she snuck in.
Oh, she did not sneak in. Yeah. Has to answer it. She got to answer the question, the pop quiz.
Yeah, pop quiz, Rashida. Here you go.
Okay.
Go
ahead, Kim.
Do you have a way that you're capturing the emails or following up with the people that you're doing help outs with?
I'm sorry, can you repeat the question again?
Do you have a way that you are capturing the emails or following, being able to follow up with the people that you're doing a help outs with?
No, I just use that messaging service through Helpouts where I send a message and I respond to it, and that's the only way. And if I can go further, I may send my email. I don't know if it's appropriate. Some people, they suggest their email and they use it. That's all. That's that. But also, as a chef, I always put, the first thing I put, my website, just to help them. Most of the time, they're asking for a recipe, a dish, and I already have the recipe on the site. And by looking at the site, they can find me on Facebook and Google Plus and all of that, and they start following me immediately. That's 90% of the people. And that way I can communicate with them, another way of communicating with them. That's basically it.
Awesome. Hey, Rashida, hold on for one sec really quick, please. So, Kim, let's go ahead and close the show. And we don't have to leave immediately, but we can stop the broadcast. What do you think, my friend?
Okay, that sounds good to me.
All right. This is Jeff Bond and signing off. Thanks, everybody, for participating. And, Kim, you can close this out.
Bye, y'all. Thanks for coming.
Bye.